guys, it's Stacy here. Welcome to my channel, Life's a Project, where I like to share my everyday life projects with you. So today's project, I'm thinning out my radish seedlings that I planted in this hanging basket. And guys, if you missed that video, you can go back and check it out. So you can see I got pretty good germination. These seeds I purchased last year, so I made sure to plant more than one seed in each planting hole. So I'm really glad that I planted more than one seed per planting hole, because most of these, only one seed germinated. Now, some of these two germinated, and I even have a little bald spot where it looks like neither seed germinated. So if your seeds are older, it's a good idea to plant more than one seed per planting hole. And I want my radishes to be happy and healthy, so you have to give them room. If you have two seedlings growing in one spot or just too close together, your radishes, or the root part, the part that you want to eat, is going to be misshapen or is going to be just small. So when your seedlings are around this size or at this stage of growth, you really want to get in there and thin them down to one seedling per space. And the same goes for other root vegetables like carrots and beets and things like that. When it's time to thin your seedlings, you want to make sure you're using some type of scissors, small pruners, or something like these Fiskars snips. I really like these. They're a great size. They're smaller. You can get in there. They're really sharp. And you can make sure you take out the seedling that you don't want to keep and not accidentally, you know, remove them both. So you can see here, when choosing the one to keep, you want the one that looks the happiest, the healthiest, the stronger one, the larger one. So you can see here, compared to this one right here, it's just a perfect example. This one, a lot smaller leaves. It's starting to form true leaves, but you can see these here. These baby leaves are a lot bigger. You can see the true leaves here a lot bigger. So overall, this plant just looks larger. It looks happier, healthier compared to this little guy down here. So I'm going to go ahead and get in here and get rid of the smaller seedling. Now, when you remove the weakest seedling, you want to make sure that you get in there and just cut it off at the soil level, at soil surface, because you don't want to just pull them up by the root and damage the other seedling, or pull up both seedlings and then you would try to replant that and it may not do well for you, because some plants do not like their roots disturbed. Now, certain plants, like tomato seedlings, you can dig those up, separate those out, and replant them, and they do great for you. But just certain plants do not. So it's always safe to just go ahead and get in there and just cut away the one that you don't want. So I have them down to one seedling per space, and now these radishes will have room to grow to their nice mature size and be happy and healthy. And thinning seedlings is pretty simple, but many of you may not know why you do it or how to do it, so I thought this video would be helpful. So if you have any questions or comments, place those down in the comment section below. Now, I wanted to give you a quick fun update, because in my other hanging basket, I planted these Tom Thumb dwarf peas. And guys, they have germinated and they look fantastic. So I'm really happy with this project. I thought it'd be fun to kind of show you how it was going. I hope to give you another update later on. So make sure you are subscribed to my channel. You can follow me on Instagram. I hope you enjoyed this video, guys, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.